There's a lot of times, there's a lot of situations in which we're studying something pretty straightforward, and we can find an exact theoretical probability. So what am I talking about? So let me write that down. Theoretical probability. Well, maybe the simplest example, or one of the simplest examples, is if you're flipping a coin. And let's say in theory you're flipping a completely fair coin, and you're flipping it in a way that is completely fair. Well, there you know you have two outcomes. The coin will either result, either heads will be on top or tails will be on top. And so theoretically you say, well look, if I want to figure out the probability of getting a heads, in theory I have two equally likely possibilities, and heads is one of those two equally likely possibilities. So you have a 1/2 probability. And once again, if in theory the coin is definitely fair, it's a fair coin and it's flipped in a very fair way, then this is true. You have a one half probability. We could also do that with rolling a die. A fair six-sided die is going to have six possible outcomes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And if you said, what is the probability of rolling a or getting a result that is greater than or equal to 3? Well, we have six equally likely possibilities. You see them there. And in theory, if once again, if they're all equally likely, four of these possibilities meet our constraint of being greater than or equal to 3. So we have four out of the six equal of these possibilities meet our constraints. So we have a 2/3. 4/6 is the same thing as 2/3 probability of it happening. Now these are for simple things like die or flipping a coin. And if you have fancy computers or spreadsheets, you can even say, hey, I'm going to flip a coin a bunch of times and do all the combinatorics and all of that. But there are things that are even beyond what a computer can find the exact theoretical probability. Let's say you're playing a game, say football, American football, and you wanted to figure out the probability of scoring a certain number of points. Well, that isn't very simple, because that's going to involve what human beings are doing. Minds are very unpredictable, how people will respond to things. The weather might get involved. There might be, someone might fall sick. The ball might be wet, or you know, just how the ball might interact with some player's jersey. Who knows what actually might actually result in the score being a one point this way, or 7 points this way, or 7 points that way. And so for situations like that, it makes more sense to think more in terms of experimental probability. And experimental probability, we're really just trying to get an estimate of something happening based on data and experience that we've had in the past. So for example, let's say that you had, this is data from your football team, and it's a couple of games or many games into the season, and you've been tabulating the number of points. You have a histogram of the number of games that scored between 0 and 9 points. You had 2 games that scored between 0 and 9 points, 4 games that scored between 10 and 19 points, including or 10 from 10 to 19 points. You have 5 games that went from 20 to 29 points. You had 3 games that went from 30 to 39 points, and then you had 2 games that go from 40 to 49 points. And let's say for your next game, and let's see, you've already had two, let's see how many games you've had so far. This is 2, let me write it down. The game so far is 2 + 4 + 5 + 3 + 2, so this is what, 6 plus, this is 6 plus 5 is 11, 11 plus 5 is 16. So you've had 16 games so far this season. And you're curious, for your 17th game, so let me write this, game 17, you want to figure out what is the probability of your points are greater than or equal to 30. Your points are greater than or equal to 30 for game 17. So once again, this is very hard to find the exact theoretical probability. You don't know exactly. You can't predict the future. You don't know who's going to show up sick, how humans are going to interact with each other. Maybe someone screams something in the stand that just phases the quarterback in exactly the right or the wrong way. You don't know. This is an incredibly, incredibly complex system, what might happen over the course of an entire football game. But you can estimate what will happen based on what you've seen in your past experience. And you know, it depends on the defense of the team you're facing and all of that. So it's not going to be, it's not going to be super exact. But you can estimate based on experiments, based on what you've seen in the past. Here, the experimental probability, and I would say the probability, the estimate, because I would I don't, you know, you shouldn't walk away saying this, okay, we absolutely know for sure that if we conducted this next game experiment n times, that it's definitely going to turn out the same. Because this might be the toughest defense that you play all year. This might be the easiest defense that you play all year. But if you look at what's happened in the past, out of the 16 games so far, there have been three games, these three plus these two games, where you scored more than, greater than, or equal to 30 points. So 5 out of the 16 situations, you scored more than that. So an estimate of your probability, and you could view this as maybe your experimental probability, of scoring more than 30 points based on past experience, is 5. 5 out of the 16 games you've done this in the past. So you'd say it's 5/16. Now, I want to really have you take this with a grain of salt. You should not, you know, then go say, okay, I know for sure there's a 5/16 probability of us winning this game. Because you only have some data points. Every team you play is going to be different. It's going to be different weather conditions. People are going to be in different moods, et cetera, et cetera. This is really just an estimate. I feel even a little bit of reservations even calling it a probability. I would just say that this has been true of 5 out of 16 games in the past, so it's an indicator of what you might say, oh, okay, you know, based on experience, it's more likely than not that we don't score more than 30 points. But it's really just based on experiential data, what's happened in the season. You know, even the makeup of your football team might have changed. You might have gotten a different coach. You might have learned to train better. Who knows? One of your team members might have grown by 3 inches. All of these things. So all of this has to be taken with a grain of salt. But this is one way of thinking about it, at least having a sense of what may happen.